Well, hello and welcome to the Frontline Sanctuary. I'm so pleased that you're with us tonight. My name is Tiffany Flowers. I'm the director of the Frontline, and I am here to welcome you. I hope that you're comfortable. I hope that you're seated or maybe laying somewhere comfortably and ready to receive in the gift that is our friend, Gina Breedlove. If you've never joined us on the front line here in our Frontline Family Sanctuary, I welcome you. If this is your first time rocking with us, come on in because you know we've been waiting for you. And if you've joined us before for any of our political education or mass calls, the self-care events we've had together over the years, dinners, concerts, and even game nights, welcome home. We missed you. We have been rocking together for the last 4 years. This is the last year of the Frontline, and one of our final gifts to our friends in the audience is the world-renowned grief doula and sound healer, Gina Breedlove. Gina, before I get into Gina, I'd like to tell you a little bit more about the Frontline. The Frontline is a Black woman-led multiracial alliance of the Working Families Party, the Rising Majority, the Movement for Black Lives Electoral Justice Project, and United We Dream. We were born in the wake of the historic 2020 summer of 2020 uprisings that flooded the streets with millions of people, including many of you, demanding change and defending our right to fight for racial justice while organizing to protect our right to vote. We took that energy from the streets to the ballot box and continued out for these past 4 years. This year, we're happy again to bring you the one and the only, the magnificent, the gorgeous, the graceful, and the amazing, amazing Gina Breedlove. Gina is a vocalist, a composer, an actor, a traditional sound healer, and she's from Brooklyn, New York, the real Brooklyn, New York. She created a program called The Vibration of Grace, Healing Through Sound, and it helps thousands of people worldwide to rediscover and deepen their power. Gina's performance credits include the Lion King stage musical, and she also tours performing her own work. As a recording artist, Gina has created three original albums, Open Heart, Language of Light, and The Star. You can learn a lot more about Gina at ginabreedlove.com. It is my distinct pleasure, honor, and joy to introduce my friend, Gina Breedlove. And welcome you all to a beautiful evening of healing.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, dear Tiffany. Thank you. Grateful for you. Good evening. Welcome, good family. I'm happy to be in this space with you. I'm honored, actually. And it's good to be seen. I will echo what our beloved Tiffany just invited you to do. Please, if you are able, do lay down. What's that song? Lay down. Lay all the way down if you can. I know that that might not be possible. Some folk are joining us while preparing dinner and holding space with their family. But if you're able to, please do. And if you are seated, please allow where you are sitting to support your body. So lean back. That's the invitation. And if you can, take your eyes off of the screen. Rest your eyes, please. If you are following our wonderful interpreters, rest your eyes on them. If you are reading the captions, rest your eyes there. But do try to take your eyes off of me. It does help, I promise, with moving through the meditation. And so, softening or closing your eyes, if you are able, lean into the sound of my voice. Lean into what you can hear. And that means, family, as our beloved Tiffany shared, I am from Brooklyn. I'm from 1970s Brooklyn. Yes, that's Brooklyn. And I grew up in Brooklyn and I know what it is to live outside of and around lots and lots of sound and activity. Neighbors and street traffic and sound, music coming through the walls, all the things. So when we do our work in this way, we invite you not to try to ignore the sound of life around you, but rather to choose what you will focus on. Right? That's the practice. So while things are happening on your end of things, like I'm in a house with my two littles, my grandchildren, and I hear them now, and maybe you will hear them too before we close our time together. It becomes part of the offering. It becomes part of the moment. So we don't resist the sounds. Again, we lean into what I invite you to lean into, which at this moment, please, is the sound of my voice. So listening and leaning into my voice, if you are laying or sitting back, allowing wherever you are to support you. Inhaling and exhaling at your own pace. Let us locate ourselves, our breath, this moment, our body, with a breath. Inhaling through your nose, please, to the extent of your capacity, as much as your body can receive. Inhale, and then exhale through your mouth. Do repeat that cycle. Cycle that breath. Again, at your own pace, inhaling through your nose and exhaling. And if you have access to sound today, please exhale with a ha. If you do not, lean into mine, my sound. Inhaling through your nose, exhaling, ah. Or inhaling deeply and exhaling quietly. Please lean into whatever your capacity is this day and this moment. All invitation from me. Please anchor it in what you have capacity for, what your access needs are today. Inhaling through your nose. Exhaling through your mouth. And just breathing is all. If the mind does what the mind loves to do, it tries to guide you out of the room, because we all know there's plenty to think about. Please tell the mind, I'll be back. Give the mind an occupation. Right? Ask the mind to consider all the things that you can hear in this moment. Yes, my voice. You will hear the sound of my drum and the sound of my bowl. But any other sounds that may be happening, lean into what you can hear. And your breath, please. Inhaling through your nose. Exhaling through your mouth. If you can soften, close your eyes, or rest your eyes elsewhere, please do. As you are breathing, fam, please consider this affirmation. We've been working with this affirmation the last 2 weeks. We're gonna work with it some more. My body is my sanctuary, and I am always home. As you inhale and exhale, and notice what a deep breath may be doing to your body at this moment, like are your shoulders dropping? Are your hands unfurling? Are you able to lean all the way back wherever you are and allowing the space to support you? And consider, my body is my sanctuary and I am always home. Notice, please, your body's response to that with curiosity. In our work together, we encourage you to be as gentle and generous with yourself as you are with those beings that you love. So noticing how the body responds is curious, right? Having curiosity, not trying to sift through it or dissect it or hold it in your hands right now. Just noticing. As you inhale through your nose, exhale through your mouth, my body is my sanctuary and I am always home. If you are able to join me now in this knowing by thinking it as I say it or saying it with me, please do. Let us inhale together and exhale, my body is my sanctuary and I am always home. And maybe as you say this, family, as you breathe, lay a hand or both hands as you are able on your face, the base of your neck, your shoulders, your stomach area, resting on your knees. Again, as you are able and as you feel guided. Inhaling through your nose and exhaling through your mouth at your own pace. Not resisting all the sounds of the moment, but do find your way to my voice. My body is my sanctuary. My body is my first home. My body, my skin. The layers and layers and layers of epidermis. The thousands upon thousands, literally thousands of pores that cover your skin. Consider your skin. Entry points for sound, yes, and for other things, but for sound. So what is the sound that you need at this moment to soothe, right? To deepen your breath and to soothe your body. My body is my sanctuary and I am always home. What sound on your own skin do you need tonight, family? And inside of locating your beating heart. Locating your beating heart. Inhaling and exhaling and locating your beating heart now. Inhaling and exhaling at your own pace. Perhaps laying a hand across your beating heart, if you are able. But finding your way to the vibration of the beating of your heart, the rhythm, the sound, the frequency, your frequency. What's your heart doing right now? Is it con 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 con? Find your way to your heart, family. Your heart and your breath. This is where we are going to live for a little while. Inhaling and exhaling at your own pace. And locating your beating heart there, 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 on the left, there. Please be there for a moment. Be there, rest there, be there. Be there, rest there, be there. Be there, rest there, be there. Your heart. So consider your heart now. It has been with you since time. In my tradition, my teacher tells me that your beating heart, that our heart, your heart and my heart, is the first sound we hear. In that watery realm, where we are all breathing underwater. The first sound, not their heart, not the body that is holding your body, not the womb that holds the body that holds the womb that holds the body, and all the ways that we know ourselves, the they, the us, the we, the them, the she, the hers, the his, all of the ways. The first sound, my teacher and their teacher and their teacher before them, is your own heart. Now imagine that for a moment. That first spark of consciousness. Your heart, your heart, your heart, your heart. Gong, 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 gong. Beating, beating, beating marrow into bones, beating blood into the highways and byways of veins and arteries, forming organs, the liver, the lungs, the kidneys, the pancreas, the spleen, your stomach, intestines, the long and the short, and the short and the long of it. Imagine that your heart, flesh, flesh, skin over flesh, skin over flesh, flesh over bone, your heart. And then you hear the heart of the one, of the body that is holding your body. And then entrainment begins. Gong, 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 gong. In time. Hearts beating in time. Your heart. In my tradition family, the heart is the altar of the body. If that language is not your language, think about any sacred space where we honor beloveds, things that you cherish, found treasures, crystals, stones, feathers, pictures, art, flowers, fresh water. So please connect those two thoughts now. Your heart being the sacred place where you can go and visit and spend time with yourself. A place where you may find quiet. Just the frequency and the beating of you. Your heart that has beat through the last 4 years. Your heart that it has experienced the grace of joy, of pleasure, of that first sip, that 7-day kiss, and pain, and the unimaginable, and grief, and the witnessing of horror. Your heart with you when you close your eyes at night, and when you open your eyes to greet the new day, there, always there. Constant and true. Let us pause and turn toward and breathe and listen. Place your hand there and feel. Find your heart, family. And while you are there, consider this incredible, potent, powerful, all the language, gorgeousness in your body. The fluid that circles the heart. In science, it is called the pericardium fluid. But why don't we, for our ritual tonight and our visioning, why don't we think of it as a stream? Fresh and sweet water around your heart. Come go with me. We are imagining a tranquil place. What does it taste like, feel like? How does it nourish you? How does the stream protect your heart from chafing against the ribs? Like, what does it do? What is its function? Imagine it. Be with your heart and your breath. My body is my sanctuary. and I am always home. And breathe deeply, dear family. Inhale through your nose, exhaling through your mouth to the extent of your capacity. Imagine and breathe. Some days, as we move through our day, the world, holding the positions that we hold for our loves, for ourselves, in our community, in all the ways that we do, in all the ways that we do, through witness, through nourishing, through asking for help, through giving help, through laying in bed or sitting and staring, wherever, however you know. Some days, some moments, going inside and remembering, locating our heart, and remembering this river and those four glorious chambers in the heart, this incredible organ. Remembering that and treating it as the altar in your body, that sacred place where you bring things, where you bow, where you give thanks, where you honor, where you remember all that it has got you through and that you are still here. Some days, that's what we've got. The quiet and the tranquility of the inside, of the inside, of the inside of our beating heart, family. Some moments be like that. Some moments be like that. My body is my sanctuary, and no matter where I am, if I am traveling, no matter where I am living, what I am witnessing, what I am going through, what my people are experiencing here and on the other side of the world, going to the heart for a moment to breathe and locate yourself and remember, well, remember your name. Remember who and how you love, what you love, what organization are you aligning your name and your word and your sound? Where are you standing, sitting, laying, being, thinking? Where is your heart beating in tandem, in shared agreement? Where? How? What is it? This moment. Of you, of us. While you cradle, notice, turn toward, lean in to your beating heart. Notice if there is some grief there, fam. Notice. Oh, I will share with you, I had the best cry today. I wailed. Holding space means I have to stay in my rituals. I am doing what I invite you to do. Because moving that grief that gets queued up in the throat and in the body and here, it makes thought almost impossible. Certainly strategizing. Moving it creates a spaciousness for you, for your wisdom, for your plan, for your ask, for your receiving, for your reach. It's the same gesture, you see. It is the same gesture. I am giving and I am receiving. Moving it, it brings us back to the heart. It brings us back to ourselves. It helps us to orient ourselves, to locate ourselves. And it is honorable. It is honoring to grieve, to move it, to literally go get it. I promise you, that song on repeat, that poem, that movie, that thing that helps you to locate, because I know what it is when it backs up on us. Because your heart and my heart and their heart, his, her, we, they, she, they, them, the us of it all, inhaling and exhaling at your own pace, family. Here's what I know. The heart, the blood, the dark red, bright red. What a deep breath does to the blood as it moves around and brings oxygen, renews the will, moving from organ to organ to organ, all from the heart, the heart. Inhaling and exhaling at your own pace, and please allow wherever you are to support you. Leaning back, laying down, anchoring. In your heart and my heart, and those of us on this call today, already in shared agreement, and then sending love forth. Prayer, poem, psalm, from your tradition. From your tradition, whatever your tradition, letting go of a good word, a good word, a good thought. The heart. I need y'all to remember. I need you to remember. It can be the sound that calls you back to yourself. In all of the chaos of cacophony, all the competition and the war for your consciousness, you can pause. Presence, awareness, using sacred expression. The breath, the breath, the breath, the breath. I'm here, I'm here, I'm here, I'm here. I live, I live, I am, I am, I. What is your heart saying to you? What's your heart song? What's your soul tone? You. Inhaling and exhaling. Let us think about love. Hold it. Consider in all the facets. Call in now, please. Perhaps that favorite flower or taste or smell, you know, beginning there, that person, that four-legged, that being, that sky, that community, that intentionality, that piece of art. My mother's mother, the father's sons, the they, the them, the us. How do we love? Think about love. And think about your heart. the power of sound and song. From your tradition, what is the sound? What is the song? What is the prayer, the poem, the sonnet? What is the word? What is the thought? What is the color? What is the vision? What is the knowing? What is it that you can also place or remember the soundtrack of your heart? All that we can employ and lean into to stay in our body, with our body, in our breath. Whatever that means for you, family, I understand that we have different relationships to language, to the heart. And that's all right. This is the invitation, and then make it what you make it so that it may be of service to your body being your sanctuary and you being home here. Here. Home. If you are able, please inhale and exhale and bring a hum to your exhale, or maybe yours will be musical, or whatever you need. It's the vibration. It's the vibration of the feeling of it in your skin. The sound of your voice vibrating. Thoughts of that as well, fam. Remember how the mamas of mamas of mamas of mamas of mamas, how it would come down, what you think about, what you speak into being, you will greet it. Think about that, please. Plant a good word in your skin, in your own heart. Think a good word. If you need to cry, wail, moan, lean into it, please. If you are able, hold yourself or imagine yourself wrapped, held by the sound of my voice, by what you love, by that good water you're going to get in later, you know, that shower or that medicine bath, by the wind on your skin, by the dirt that anchors wherever you be. The soil that has memory, and those who have come way before, evidence of things seen and unseen, but felt, known by you, what you know. When you can move that grief and clear the mind and remember your name. Hum, family. Hum and be with your heart and breathe and allow yourself to be held and move. Move the energy that feels caught in the throat, in the stomach, lurking in the liver. Place your hand there and move it with your thoughts, with your sound. Hearts beating in shared agreement. Hearts greeting each other in tandem. Shared agreement. Let us vision now and let us hold The ritual of simultaneity. The ritual still of anchoring in what is possible, even while we are watching the fraying and the undoing of things. What worlds may come? Consciousness is a power. We know that. We know that. And trust and believe, the evils of this time are coming for your mind. What they say, we wrestle not with flesh and blood, but principality. And you need me, and I need you. I need you. To care for yourself, to ritualize care as you are able. What does that look like? Only you know for you. But the position I hold, let us hold our hearts in our hands as we are able and move the grief, family. And there's other ways besides wailing, although I love a good wail. There's movement as you are able. There's visioning, the power of the imaginal. Remember when you knew the moon was following you? I live with littles. I get to roll around in it and remember my own little self, who is so much more than any trauma she endured. She's bright and funny. Your little is too. Like leaning in, family, to the power that we have. So inhaling and exhaling at your own pace, beloveds. At your own pace. At your body's pace. And spending some time in sacred agreement with your own beating heart. Notice your body. Notice your shoulders. Notice. Notice. And listen. Let's talk about anger. Look, I like to get mad. Believe it or not, it's fire. And it can, jumpstart a thing. Get me moving, get me in the streets, get me to reaching, get me to creating space, get me to helping, to witnessing, to doing. But I want to say, I don't want us building property there. Not in anger. It will harm us over time. Please. I'm not mad at anger. But as long as I am moving it through, like grief, what is sustainable for my body, for my liver? What is? So notice, please, what you need. Because I know that grief and anger are kin. They are kin. And there's plenty to be angry about. I get that. But don't let it live in your throat, in your liver, in your heart. Don't let it stay there for long. There are plenty of ways to move it. I've shared a few. Grieving is one way. There are rituals for moving anger, family. A simple one that I can access right now and share with you. Old plates knotted in a sheet. That hammer on those plates, don't harm yourself. This ain't about harming yourself. It's about moving energy. If you are able, if you're not able to do those movements, I imagine it, envision it. And then I add my sound to it. And then I dance. Ooh, I will put on Chaka Khan and move around this house. Or some house music, listen. If you don't know, I done told you, go find out. I'm talking about how do we keep our bodies well inside, all of, and around this present moment so we can show up for the lives we are giving ourselves. And for the love that we are giving ourselves in all the facets of love, all the ways love grows between us. All the ways. And then the heart. So my heart will beat in time with your heart in shared agreement, y'all, of true freedom. What is that? I vision it daily. Where all beings are safe. Nourished, where women, folk, all of us together, however you know yourself to be, have full agency and autonomy over your everything. We're in shared agreement. I got you and you got me in the ways that you are able, in shared agreement. Shared agreement. And I will witness your grief, and I will witness your joy, and I will witness all of your feels, because they yearn, they're yours. And I will meet you at the beating heart, family, at the river, at the stream around the heart. And I will plant there with you fields of yellow. Oh, that image is my favorite one. Can you see it in your eye, in your mind, from that pineal gland? Can you see fields of yellow flowers? Where we re-up at the well of love and then rise. And hold our position. For that new day we know is coming. Inhaling and exhaling. And breathe. As we turn toward closing, please call into your spirit what you love. Lean into right now. Remember one of your best days. If you are graced the way I feel graced, you have a few to choose from. Right now, my best day, and has been for a while, is the day my grandson was born. Here in my home. Underwater, y'all. Triple Earth sign. I mean Capricorn, Taurus rising, and Virgo moon. Who is this person gonna be? Guiding his head from my daughter's body underwater. And then bringing him up toward air. Yes. Come on and pull from one of your best days right now. Remember it, please. Source it. It is a kind of medicine. We better, so that we can fight the good fight, or use the language that makes sense in your mouth. But source that good day like it is the sweetest butter or ghee or what's your jam. Use it is the point. Lean into it. Oh, I cover myself with that memory. I remember. It's like suiting up. In that love, anchoring me and remembering why I do what I do. Please source a good day, a good memory. Pull it close, y'all. Nourish yourselves with it. Nourish yourself with it. Lean into it. And breathe. And then the heart and the sound and your name and all the things that you use, lean into, and employ to circle yourself, to circle your heart. To keep believing in love. Your best day. We are turning toward closing our time together now, beloveds. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for being in the space. For sharing about what we're doing here and for returning. Thank you. As I turn to close, those who walk with you will walk with you, and those who walk with me will walk with me. Until such time, and not until we decide to open the space between us again, and when we do, we will be more ourselves. Take care. Good folk, get into water, hydrate well, have some nourishing food, it grounds. Have that good, good cry if you ain't done yet. Put on that song that makes you dance and twirl as you are able, or imagine it, see it. See it. I will see it with you. And you know how we close. You know how we close with the medicine of Stevie Wonder. You know how we do? So please, family, let us make that offering. Turn it up, turn it up, turn it up.
For your joy and pain, and I'll be loving you always. That's the day I know I'm living, but tomorrow would make me the past, for that I mustn't fear, for I'll know.